This morning, Dr. Jeff and his team are heading to a dog rescue to offer free vet care and to share some donated supplies.
We got a call from Teresa with National Mill Dog Rescue. She's coming back with a load of dogs from the puppy millers. The bottom line is these animals tend to be in pretty bad shape and she wants us to check them out. Teresa goes out and rescues dogs. In the last 9 years, they have adopted over 10,000 animals, all of which are spayed or neutered. So they get them in and rehab them and then get them home. So it's pretty impressive overall. Puppy mill is basically mass production of various types of so-called purebred dogs. Most of these puppy millers keep these animals in deplorable conditions, and they get a certain age, they're no longer cute enough, then you kill them or you give them away. You just never know the condition of the animals. Well, we beat you down here.
Oh, man.
How long you been driving?
Oh, wow. 18 hours,
yeah.
Like that.
Wow. If it wasn't for Teresa, these dogs would all be killed.
There's a couple we're concerned about on here.
Teresa from National Mill Dog Rescue has just saved 28 dogs from puppy mills in Arkansas, Oklahoma, and Nebraska.
Let's get Lily off. This one, she's really old. She's got a bunch of sores underneath her, and she's just been really pretty despondent.
How old is she?
She's about 12, I think, yeah. She just looks like she's infected. She comes from a place that's notoriously pretty horrible.
And she's actually breeding this dog?
Breeding that dog, yep.
This is neglect. She should be in jail.
Yeah, understood. Yeah.
All right. If you had an animal like that and you brought it to my facility and you didn't want to do anything about it, I could have you prosecuted for neglect, you know? But these people get away with it in huge numbers, and it's appalling to me.
This one is Joyce. She's very timid. In a puppy mill, they're all in small wire cages. They have an automatic feeder, just enough to keep everybody alive and breeding. She's never been out of a cage. Never ever been held. It's called swimming like that. That behavior comes from a dog who's never, ever been off wire. They're just not used to being up off the ground. And she's missing an eye. Poor baby.
We can take her so that we can do the surgery on her?
Yeah. I brought Susan, and Susan is looking at dogs, so I'm sure she's going to bring at least 3 or 4 back with us.
You can do it!
Come here, baby.
Oh!
I feel overwhelmed when I come here every time, and this is the first time I've seen them actually coming off just getting here. It's really hard to see and think that someone would treat anything like that.
28 dogs are offloaded. Time to go inside, get everybody taken care of.
National Mill Dog Rescue. They're actually probably one of the few organizations along the Front Range that actually spays and neuters 100% of animals prior to adoption. And that's the way every humane society should be. So we're just gonna help them out with some of their surgeries.
Baby girl.
Next, buddy.
Just remove both his testicles. Gonna close him up and we're done.
While Dr. Jeff and Hector spay and neuter some of the rescue's current residents.
All right, got the next one.
Teresa and her team care for the dogs just brought in.
So Lily came in on this rescue and she's a priority medical dog for us right now. She's very shut down. She has sores all over her body. We need to be able to see what the sores, where they are and what they look like. It's just revealing more and more sores all over her body. Not sure what that is. Wow, this is pretty significant. Lily, we don't want to handle too much when we're trying to dry her, just because she's got so many sores.
Jeff, you know that doc, it's almost pretty tore up looking? They just gave it a bath and it has wounds all over it.
I gotta take a look.
I'll have them ready in between your next ones.
Nice ulcer in that eye. Looks like dry eye in that eye. So what are you showing me?
She has a bunch of little cuts on her neck.
Oh, yeah, she does. I don't think those are bites, though. I think she has horrible skin and her poor feet.
Yeah, her feet are a mess for sure.
Yeah. Poor baby. If I pull that much it's just going to crack and bleed. There's an abscess right there. And part of that's probably because she's been sitting down on wire. Soaking those feet in betadine is really nice, and the warmth will feel kind of good, and it doesn't really burn, so. She's got horrible allergies. Oh, she's supposed to be a Westie.
Yeah.
And they're notorious for horrible allergies.
Allergies early.
Good thing they're breeding this dog.
Yeah, for sure, for 10, 11 years.
The general rule for skin, if it's moist, you make it dry. If it's dry, you make it moist. So right now, it's kind of gooey underneath there, so you can use kind of an astringent type shampoo. I got one more animal to fix. I'm gonna get that one done.
All right.
Donated a bunch of stuff to us, and we thought we'd bring some down and give it to you.
I can have that one. Oh, wow, cool. Leashes, treat. Oh my gosh, this is awesome. Soft treats for our little guys.
Over here. Got the balls over here.
This is awesome. By Christmas, it's gonna go right into this little toy box. Awesome. We're super grateful. Thank you, guys. All right. Hey, Miss Lil, baby. Hey, sweetheart, you're gonna be in here a little bit so we can keep an eye on you, okay? Hey, baby boy, she moves gingerly, huh?
Yes.
That's a bed. I don't know what a bed is. Here. You don't know what a hand is either, do you, kiddo? Huh? Yep, 11 years to get out of that place.
That's
unbelievable.
A long time.
She's never seen anything but a wire cage, ever. Never, ever. She's a broken spirited dog. Her whole entire life, her worth has been measured in only one way, and that's her ability to produce puppies.
Well, look at you.
So here we are,
all
huh, kiddo?
All ready to start your new life.
Oh, baby girl. Yeah, look at that. Oh, it's soft underneath your feet, huh? You gonna lay down in there? That's for you. That's why we do it.
Ready to get on the road.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
I can't thank you enough. And then taking some doggies
home.
We'll
see you soon.
Susan, Jeff, and Hector are taking four of the dogs back up to Planned Parenthood for adoption. Susan's always willing to jump in and take a couple of those really difficult dogs, so we're always very grateful for that.
I'm Bubbers. Teresa does a great job. I'm always going to try to help people that really care about animals.
All right, y'all. Take care.
Hey, take care.
We'll see you, okay?
See you, Teresa.
All right, bye, guys.